All right, we are down to four races left in the season. Currently 31st overall in points, but that's pretty much just because we're one of the few that have ran almost all the races. Only 29 races count for points out of the season, so missing Coda wasn't too big of a deal, other than I had wanted to complete the whole season. But here's our first time in Texas, and yeah, it's kind of weird to say that with the season almost over. And that got me to thinking, like, NASCAR has been everywhere and tons of small ass places. Like, they've been to Nebraska at Lincoln County Speedway back in the 50s. So I figured there's got to be quite a few places they've been in Texas. Texas is pretty big. You would assume they've been to a lot of places. Well, first track they ever went to in Texas, Texas World Speedway. Second track they ever went to is Myer Speedway in Houston. It was a paved half mile. They only ran there once and only 14 cars showed up. And then here, Ancona. Only four tracks. And yeah, that seems weird that there was a massive gap between the late 80s and whenever Texas Motor Speedway was built. I assume that was like mid 90s, maybe late 90s. But it's NASCAR's had a really weird history. Like the 71 race in Houston, it was part of a 48 race schedule, and it got Winston pissed off apparently because only 14 cars showed up, only 11 finished, and it was won by two laps. And yeah, they said nope, there needs to be a higher standard. So Texas World Speedway worked out. I don't know the whole reason why it quit. I'm assuming with it only being capable of kart, IndyCar, USAC, whatever you want to call it back in the 70s, and NASCAR. I know ARCA had went there in the early 90s from what I saw, but I don't know the whole story behind it. I am sure money, change of ownerships, constantly losing money. Anyways, that's the history of NASCAR in Texas, and they had a pretty good track with this one until they ruined it. And then, of course, we all know what happened in COTA that got all the current fans all angry with rain racing, which was kind of a, well, it was a really stupid system. Put the lights in the like bumper or somewhere that's not in the window. I think that would help, but visibility is always going to suck in these. So, yeah, let's go around. Paint scheme for this, I didn't really put too much thought in it. I did the sides. And then I decided it was too boring just for sides only. So I did the front. And then I decided I needed something on the hood to tie the front to the sides. And now it looks like a evil catfish, maybe. So I don't know what the hell I was going for. I mean, there wasn't really much. Why is the keyboard not working? That's not good. Are my F keys working? My F keys are not working. What is happening? Damn it, why does shit not work right when num lock? Nope. Caps lock? Nope. All right, we are going to restart the game real quick because I definitely need to be able to change my F keys and see the incidents after the race or midway in the race or whenever the hell it's going to happen. Least I wasn't planning on qualifying. Yeah, I don't know what caused that. I've had that happen once before. Maybe it was because I was paused in the practice session before I moved on to the race, which can cause issues. Or at least I've had it cause issues before. Strength field 4,411, it is saying. And yeah, we're not going to qualify. I know that it's a draft track and it's going to be hard to do anything with the air. But when we get on track, you're going to see how loose I am in one and two. And there's absolutely no need for me to be in the pack if I start ahead of some people that qualified and then everyone else that didn't qualify. It's just, there's no need for me to be up there. I don't know. Like, it's not like I can spin out. It's this really weird, stupid loose that I can drive it like I can drive through it just fine. We're just sideways and skidding, and it feels absolutely terrible. And I see a lot of others having that issue as well, but I don't want to be the guy that causes a massive wreck. We haven't really had a massive, big screw up. There we go. All right, F keys are back. And we have camera. Why? All right, let's do this. There we go. All right, we've got camera controls now. So yeah, that is the car. Not exciting. But it's gonna do the job, which is finish dead last, most likely. I can't be good at this racing. It's, I don't know. I'm just not feeling it. So we'll hope that we have a big 20 car pile up from people spinning out, and we'll get a decent finish, decent points, and maybe get closer to the front page overall. Even though I'm in Division 2, I don't care where I'm at in Division 2 standings, because most of the people we've been racing are Division 1. So, yeah, we're just gonna, I hope, have a good race. Let everyone load up for a moment. I forgot to change Kevin's car. Sorry, Kevin. I didn't go delete out your old paint scheme. Yeah, just didn't think about it until right now. Right, let's hop in and get ready for whatever this is going to be. You know, it could go long green, but it's gonna
You have
require people to be
six additional
patient.
sets of tires during this race. Have a good race.
I've done a practice pit stop. It's fairly easy to get on pit road. we just, I'm just way too loose. And even when the car is tight after a bit, I'm still way too loose. So just not sure what to do. But changing anything to tighten it up will just make us worse. So just gonna power through. Hope. Looks like we have a cooler air temp. So we got that. We are at the back, and with these starts, it can make you pretty damn far behind if you don't get out and catch up to the pack. Since the leader in the pace car left a long time ago, and they are already in the middle of... They're about to start the race, and I don't know what the fuck we got going on here. Well, we got a clusterfuck is what we got. We're not going to be starting anywhere near the field. We're going to be catching them at full speed, though, so that should be awesome. Alright, well, we didn't get screwed over too bad there. I have no idea what those guys were doing, but that should spread the field out a bunch. That's why I hate that. Like, they just need to line us up on the front stretch like every other track. Got one going around. He's caught it. Everyone's checking up massively. I can't go to the outside of him because we wrecked him in the trucks. Are you fucking stupid? Oh, yes, he is. Fucking idiot. Jesus. I wasn't gonna go three wide with Don because we wrecked him going three wide on the front stretch last time, but then that dipshit runs into the back of us because he's in such a hurry since he didn't qualify. But field is very spread out and car feels much tighter, so... I don't know. I guess good thing. And there are some people that are looking really stupid loose. Notice the 34. I'm pretty sure that's the idiot that wrecked us at Bristol. So we are, we're looking good right now. Lifting off, just we got screwed over on all that, so we've still got the draft a bit. Just trying to save the tires a bit and not get too loose. But as you can see, I don't know if you saw that, but very loose there off the corner. About my anger towards the dipshit in the 27. We're just gonna forget about that so I don't run into him. And we'll let the 34 wreck him because the 34 is really good at wrecking people. And we've caught the back of the pack, so. Now it's just a long run and
30.059.
Don't get the car too loose.
these guys are going to just keep passing each other over and over. I'm not going to get anywhere near the 34. The guy is just clueless. But at least with this extra grip that we got from the air temp, we're sitting pretty on how the car feels. Any extra tape, which it's looking like we can, but I'm not really in a big draft pack, and I'm lifting off on both ends. .35's got damage. Don't know how he pulled that off. Maybe that was what caused all the stupidity on the pace lap. The high side in 1 and 2, it's way slower, but you can go up there and have it be much tighter for you. I thought that guy was losing it or something. It started to sound like he was getting closer to us. Yeah, car feels much tighter. And we can probably add some tape, but we'll see what happens. More laps on fuel, 48 to 50 more laps, so we don't have to think about that for a while. Once again, I overdrive it. Need to quit doing that because that's only going to get worse. Are falling off big time, but we've also lost the draft, so that's gonna lose us a bit of time. And I keep doing that. Got one wrecked. So I'm going to go up 6% on the tape. There's a lot of people falling off. I've just gotta catch some draft and we'll be able to kind of pull up. I hope.
30.863.
We got the three car that started from the pits. Who is a lap down, or who knows if maybe he just completely missed the start and just came out, but that will help us a bit. I'm just gonna give him the bottom because he's clearly on fresher, faster tires. And hopefully he can pull us up there just a bit more. He might be way too quick for us though.
31.082.
Yep. Alright, well. We are just stuck here. Gonna be boring for a bit.
30.85.
I'm very surprised though how tight the car has gotten. Even though we just got sideways there through the center, it is just stupid tight. So the tape on the nose is gonna help that, along with get us some more speed. Just gotta hope that it's not too late. Leaders are not on the relative yet, so a positive. I guess they're closer in front of us than they are behind us still. Just. They're 14.9 seconds ahead of us. So half a lap behind.
31.17.
Don is much quicker, so maybe we'll be able to stick with him since he's on the same tires, and he can pull us up there.
31.111.
We got a pit in 35 laps. but at least the mid-pack isn't just completely pulled away, so we still have a chance at a top 20. It's going to be very obvious with this. Get behind him. As bad as I could have made it, but hopefully we can get a little speed here now, at least on the straights. Yeah, this is gonna help us. We're gonna be a little tighter in the corner, but just getting pulled down the straightaway is going to help me, because he's going to be able to catch these guys in front, 3 and 4s, essentially just a straightaway. Thomas up there.
31.043.
Overdrove that. Loose on exit, like we're in the big block at Eldora. Still 2.1. Alright, well, that hasn't done anything for us. There we at least gained a tenth, maybe. Leaders have to be, yeah, they're 12.6 seconds behind us now. So they've only really gained 2 seconds since the last time I looked. But we are going to be lap traffic. But I think pit stops are going to happen before they catch us. Yeah, it's just, I'm not driving 1 and 2 good, and we need a bit more tape, but just have not been good. It's kind of difficult with the draft. But we're kind of in the handling phase of things, and I'm not hitting the corner right. I need to go to last lap and try to learn a better way through 1 and 2.
Four, seven.
11.9 seconds back.
51.168.
We're looking at about lap 55, 57 for the first pit stop to break everything up even. If my brain is doing math correctly. Drove it down on the apron trying something there. I can't break through this gap. The tape is going to help a lot. Almost to the point where short pit might get us in a better position, but are people just going to wreck once everyone else starts short pitting?
51.257.
I don't know. We need to look to see how many people are laps down and what that situation is. We got two people one lap down, one two laps down, then we got a 13 lap down and one guy out of the race. It's really weird though, this car really changed from practice, but I forgot to look at what practice air temps were. Thinking we pit at lap 50, try to gain some back, and if caution comes out, so be it. Yeah, we've already got some people pitting. We got, I don't know what the hell is going on with the 34, but it's the 34, so. pit at lap 50. Smoke on the front stretch. Someone coming back up on track. It's worrisome. People are starting to look like they are wanting to wreck. It's probably from pitting. Having issues getting onto pit road. We're going to assume he's going to come pit. He doesn't. Stay in the throttle and turn it down because I couldn't see if Thomas was going to hit the wall or not. Alright, we're pitting this time. It's going to be a bad call, but I got to do something because we're going to get hung up behind these guys. And the car is being weird. So, let's go ahead and go down pit road so a caution triggers. That was slow as hell. Hopefully we come out in a fairly clean space. Can run some laps until everyone else pits.
Okay, punch it.
And not have this tape make me just want to instantly loop. We're going to be two laps down. But it looks like we're going to come out in a clean spot behind the top four, and hopefully we'll be able to clear them fairly easy with the speed difference. So I'm going to say that's a pretty good spot to come out in. Ahead and make sure they're not going to pit. Shit, I can barely catch these guys on new tires. We are not in a good situation. My driving is not good. 1 and 2 is where we're gonna get the speed. Now they're gonna be too wide. Will give me a run around both of them.
30.111. Stay low. There is a car on the high side. Clear outside. Go high.
We'll have a decent run. He's going to pit, I assume. If he's not, then that's very stupid of him.
Car inside. Clear inside.
Good. He was pitting. That is a very good way to tell someone that you're about to pit. It's probably going to hurt your turn a bit, but I don't have voice, and you don't know how many people have it muted or turned off if you're saying it over that. So we're going to assume that Garrett's going to probably come in soon. We really need to get ahead of him. Because if caution comes out, we're only going to get to do a wave around for getting back to one lap. Made a big gain, but we're going to be on much older tires than everyone else.
30.052.
But hopefully we've got a bit more speed now. Still got people that haven't pit, so we're not on the lead lap yet.
Inside.
Get both of these past us.
Stay high. 30.13. Still inside. Clear inside.
Little wiggle.
Car outside. 30.22. Still there. Hold your line. Clear outside if you want to. Go high.
And lots of loose. Alright. We're definitely going quicker. And we have made up a ton of spots. There's still people yet to pit, and we're in 21st, so I think we're net 11 spots that we've gained so far. Now we could lose some of those back. And we probably will, but that was definitely a huge, huge call to get us in and gain spots and not have a caution come out. Alright, we're back on the lead lap. But the leader's still gotta be about 12 seconds behind us. So we're gonna have these guys tracking us down and passing us slowly, but we're at least back in the race. So we're just gonna get out of the way, don't get ran over. Of course, he is a pay-to-wreck idiot. Never saw that scheme on him, but makes sense now. Thomas is back behind us. luckily the 34 is way gone, and then the people that stayed out really long, they are, you know, they're going to be flying compared to us right now, but they lost a lot of time with that, so I'm happy. I think even though we're getting passed left and right, mostly left, I think we're good. Got some more smoke from something.
13.583.
Luckily we haven't had cautions. I could gladly go green the whole way. But yeah, we gained some track position, and we're still going to get lapped, only 3.4 seconds behind us. Now we're at that point where the car doesn't want to turn anymore. Yeah, we're gonna need a caution now.
30.943.
To stay on the lead lap. Looks like Garrett has really broken away from the guys that he was around, which is interesting because he was the last to pit of them, I'm pretty sure. But we have gained still 7 spots. We're going to lose a couple more in a second, but we gained 5 spots and they don't seem to be anywhere around. So, issues on pit road, slow getting on and off, who knows. Couldn't tell if that guy was pitting or just that slow. Slide up for the leader.
Inside. Stay high.
Air pushed me to the right, almost got in the wall.
Clear inside.
And now we're not even the lucky dog, so now we just need him to go lap as many people as he can. Well, how many people are a lap down? That is the big key. What the hell is going on in the backstretch? Well, we got a lot of people damaged. We got one, there are five of us a lap down.
Jets up, 22, jump.
If I take the wave around, I'm just gonna instantly get lapped again. I think our better option is hope that everyone else takes the wave around, and then we're the only one lap down. So, we'll pit, get tires, be at a decent speed. Everyone else does the wave around.
Car 22, got the lucky dog.
And
on the outside.
Then we get the lucky dog if caution comes out, because we're just waiting for a luck or waiting for a caution anyways if we're doing the wave around way. So. And now there is only two people one lap down. Oh, because I'm an idiot. So I think there's only four people a lap down now. So yeah, we're definitely going to come in, get tires. Just because we would be lapped in just a few laps anyways on old tires. So we'll come in. Not put ourselves at a disadvantage. There's a long ways to go. Tires from the last run were 47-41 and then 95-92. I hope everyone else behind us stays out and takes a wave around. Although some of the two lap down guys are going to do that, they'll still have to start behind us. And they'll be on older tires, so. We're the only lapper not taking the wave around, and I am fine with that.
Okay, punch it.
So, yeah, if a caution comes out, then, you know, we get the lucky dog, they get the wave arounds, everyone wins. If it doesn't, though, then I think we're much better off than them. And right now our battle is just to try to get a top 20. In 26 right now, first car lap down, there are three people one lap down, it's showing right now, other than me, and those guys are all taking the wave around. I think. I don't even know. No. Some of them are on pit road now, so.
One left to green. Line up on the outside.
Yeah, it's gonna be interesting.
I
just hope we survive the start, and you know, our goal, we gotta stay ahead of the guys that are on the older tires.
1:29.90.
But we also don't want an incident. And I think a couple of those people just went. Alright, so now there's only three people total, one lap down. The 35 and the 19 are who we're racing. Now the wave around people, they're gonna go get lapped again, and they will take away our lucky dog. But we've got at least 15, 20 laps until then, I think, maybe more. Our battle is not with any of these people ahead of us. we just need to stay ahead of the 35 and the 19 right now.
About to go green, stay focused. Pace car is off. Green flag, green flag.
Just gonna go high here, get non-pass. Everyone behind us should be a non-factor. And now, watch for yellow, and hope for a lucky dog. While everyone behind us hopes for a yellow just to have the wave around pay off. That's the second time this season that the 22 has stolen a lucky dog from us, like, just one lap away. Guy behind us, we're not going to worry about. I don't want anyone right on my tail. We're not racing. He is really bad at the turny thing. That guy seems like he's somewhat quick for a couple of laps and then just goes to shit. So I'm guessing he's got his car set up really tight so that it's not terrible at the start, and then it just goes really bad. But it doesn't look like anyone's going to be wrecking, so. Let him go, and then he got terrible, so we're just going to pass him, not let him slow us down too much. Yeah, he's not getting the concept of slowing down for the turn. Smoke, and we got fire. And we're the lucky dog. Unless someone just got lapped. But that works out for everyone. We are lucky dog. And we're couple of spots higher now because two or three people got hurt there. So, I'm happy with that call. We're going to go ahead and come in and get some fuel, get some tires. Because we got a lot of sets of tires. Still got four sets of tires left, so.
carbine. Catch the pace car. You are the lucky dog. Get your lap back by passing the field on the outside.
All right.
Pace car, catch the 19 car.
Pretty much everyone's back now on the lead lap. This is gonna get stupid with everyone coming out of the pits there.
26 carbine. You had the position when the yellow flag came out. Letta 18 carbine. Letta 26 carbine. Pit road is now open.
All right, behind the 26.
Passed up 22 car.
We will go get our tires and fuel and get back in this race. So yeah, either way we played it, it worked out. We're going to be starting behind everyone. There might be a few wave arounds that start behind us, but we're all good. Tires that time, 98, 97.
All clear, punch it.
35 is coming off pit road. I'm just going to let these guys go because we're going to have to start behind them anyways. So, rather than playing that stupid game of having to get behind the people that we need to be behind,
line up single file. Catch up 35. Cut.
So we're in 23rd. And yeah, definitely on target for a top 20 with people wrecking out. We've got four people a lap down still. Some of those, are they at the front? We've got one guy at the front who is taking a wave around. So everyone else is just straight up a lap down or in pits.
Because you're the lucky dog, you'll be held at the end of the longest line. One lap to green, you'll be lining up on the inside. Letta 16 carbine. You had the position when the yellow flag came out.
Hopefully no one else is coming out. I don't believe they are, so we won't have to let anyone by. And here we are in 23rd, with five people now a lap down, and might only be 27 cars left on track. It's a long ways to go. And there is still one pit stop to do as well.
Get ready, going green.
In 10 laps, 15 laps, you might be able to make it.
Pace car is off. Green, green, green.
Well, that was a piss poor start by me. We can't even out accelerate the 16.
Eight.
dude, fucking pay attention. Smoke in a car flying all over the place. No, it wasn't a yellow, but I'm not gonna fucking drive into it after just getting back on the lead lap. Not gonna pass this guy. He's quicker than us. Unfortunate. Looked like there was gonna be a wreck because he swerved back up into traffic. But here we are again. At the back. It's not like we were gonna be much further up if I didn't lift. And we've got that extra tape now, and we could probably bump it up. But I wasn't sure, pack-wise, how things were going to handle. Temp-wise, I'm going to say wise on the end of something a few more times. Wise. Being smooth at all. We did run our fastest lap by a long ways. 257 on the oil temp right now. We're not really up under anyone. Really slow. I mean, I'm driving faster this time. I'm a little more in tune with the car, but I'm just really slow. See if lap down car decides to race us. He's probably in lucky dog spot, so it'd be stupid if he did. Thank you. Maybe driving harder is going to make this not tighten up as much as it did on that first run. Touching the brake pedal, I don't know if I'm pushing it. I don't have time to look over and see. But it's making me feel better about entering the corner. We're just the back of the pack, mid-pack car. A little bit about track position, little bit about driving.
Outside.
Yeah, I'm coming through, Thomas.
Stay low. There is a car on the high side. 30.145. Still there.
I had to take that spot. We just gotta get everything we can immediately, because later on it just seems even harder to catch and pass.
30.223.
Kinda entered that one too hot, but it worked out. Last pit on lap 90. You can go 46 laps from here. I don't think they're going to be able to do a full fuel run, but I definitely think we can be lucky dog easy if we do pit early. We're going to be looking at forty to go. 40 to go will be the right time. It'll give us a couple of laps ahead of people that split it in half. And, get us ahead of this little group, I think. Unless I self-spin, because the tires are really fucking hot from that 1 and 2 loose. Nice and easy through here. Let the tires come back to us. We'll lose a little bit of time. But if I'm getting loose out of four, we definitely need to cool the tires. We're gonna bump the tape up. Side-to-side contact there, maybe again, and maybe a three wide in the tri-oval. Got a block being thrown.
30.962.
And he holds him off. And now Don's getting past on the outside. He's just pulling out of there to be safe now. I have no idea who's in the Aaron's car. He is driving really aggressive right now. Oh shit. Good save. And he still beats us off the corner because fuck, I'm terrible. Oh, he is loose from that slide and driving probably a little angry. Alright, so 127 is when we're coming in. But I might go a little earlier, because this is just a big pile of shit in front of us that is really slowing each other up. Stupid idea, but way slow on entry, and we're good. We were just gonna get held up massively there. Why not? What do we got to lose? Go 50 laps. Maybe gain a shit ton here. Should come out with a lot of clean air, and we should be able to pass most of the guys that are lapped down to get back to the lucky dogs, so. I am happy with that call. If it doesn't work out, it doesn't work out, but that was just looking like a clusterfuck that was gonna slow everyone down over and over. So we've got 7.5 seconds to the 19, and I think that gets us lucky dog. And then when we get to the clusterfuck, we'll be much quicker than them, and hopefully we'll just be able to clear it instantly. had to do something there. That was just... We weren't going to be able to do shit at that point.
29.73.
This gives us a chance, if it goes green, to jump a lot of people. And then maybe get a caution. Who knows? Who knows what it's going to do, but... I mean, what does it matter if I finish 20th or 26th? And right now it's looking like 26th is the worst I could finish, so... Let's have some fun with some strategy 4 seconds away from that lucky dog. I think we got taped just about right, where we're not running on the edge by ourselves, but we'll be right on the edge once we get behind some people. Pitting, or I don't know. Yes. .4 to Lucky Dog. Off because we're not going to be able to get around him until exit, so there we go. Lucky dog. For now, until the leader starts lapping people behind us. We still got this clusterfuck, but it's a little less clustery. If we really need to, we can pass them on the outside in 1 and 2. Alright, we got some more takers going into the pits. 30.419. Still there, hold your line. All right, so we don't have Lucky Dog anymore. That's fine. We just need Long Green. We're in 22nd at the moment.
The lead is fitting now.
That's going to pull a lot of people in now. There's still going to be a lot of people that stay out, but I think we're going to pass them fairly soon. There's a lot of cars, though, that we're seeing come out right in front of us that we have not seen all race. except for when they were lapping us when we pit the first time. Pretty sure that four car in front of us was in second or fourth last time we pit. I don't know what the fuck this guy's doing. Clearly not paying attention. Trying to block off a guy on new tires is just stupid.
30.537, go high, car outside. Clear outside.
I had to drive it in there deep just to make sure. So everyone that stays out till the latest, they're gonna be much quicker. I don't know if they'll be able to catch us, so. We are gaining a shit ton of time on the entire field at the moment. We're gonna be slow.
30.623.
But this could get us into the top 15. Now we just gotta not get ran over by everyone coming up on 10, 15 lap fresher tires. Two cars up ahead of this guy are on the lead lap, or the leaders. That will get us on the lead lap. Just trying to stay in a lane there. Knew that wasn't going to be fun. One more car to go till we're on the lead lap. I'm amazed that we've made it through all this traffic. Like, seeing these people weave in and out of each other, there hasn't been contact. I mean, this place is wide, so that helps, but... So let's let this guy go low.
6.648, you're in the top 10. Get the car inside. Clear inside.
We're in such a good spot right now that it's really stupid to force too much. Why he was turning down so much. I mean, I missed the corner, but that cost us a lot of time. We're getting really pushy. And now we're really loose from that slide. So now we see how far we fall. And stop overdriving corner entry now that we don't have to pass anyone else. We're in 13th now. There's still a lot of people that have yet to pit. Maybe two or three, but I'm gonna say that's a lot. But we're also gonna be the slowest guy on track at the moment, so. It was a fun strategy to try.
30.805. Inside. Clear inside.
13th again. The people that we were racing when we came out of the pits are now in front of us and have yet to pit, so they've taken a different strategy, but I think with their damage, maybe that's the only thing they can do. Thank you for the room. Although I hit the apron and almost killed us both. Alright, still 13th. We got a couple of fast guys coming that just came out of the pits. There's still a lot of people going really long that are going to have very little time to make up a lot of lost time. So, unless they're planning on doing two tires and a quick fuel, I think there's a few people out there that have hurt themselves. We should be able to get a top 18, I think, the way it's looking, unless I wreck. It's gonna be rough. And the leader is only 4 seconds behind us. But we still gain spots. But it's gonna get nasty in a few minutes. We're gonna start losing spots every single corner. Paid a wreck, almost got himself wrecked. Yeah, the 11 car that was looking like shit that we wanted to do this move to get around is passing us, so didn't pay off. But it was fun to think that it was going to. Puts us to 16th, and looks like we're going to be outside the top 20. This is the idiot that didn't give us any room at all, so wasn't going to give him any. You know what, when I saw the leader, that I think that was still Kevin.
The leader's pitting now.
Yeah, so not sure how far the real leader is behind us. That makes me feel a little better. 9 seconds behind, so we got a long ways until we get lapped. Levin's not pulling away too fast. Looks like Kevin might have been the only one staying out there. Fuck.
Still there.
Glad he made it around me. Yes, that got me stupid loose. gotta stop overdriving. One, not on fresh tires. Maybe we've hit our point. Maybe we've evened out with some guys in front aren't pulling away too fast. The guys behind aren't catching all that quick. Maybe can hold on to a top 20. Racing, you weren't there, so we had to dirt track it through there, but I'm going to take the line.
31.001, car inside. Stay high. Still there, inside. Still there.
Leader 7 seconds behind. Oh, Kevin's even going to pass us because he's that much faster. But he was also pretty far ahead of us before the green flag stopped, so still think it was a bad idea. Spot back. This guy's not looking that hot.
Car outside. Stay low. Still there. Still there. 31.11. Still there. Stay low, there is a car on the high side. Clear outside.
Alright. Looks like we're getting 21st. Unless I hit the wall. Car is crazy loose at the moment. Yep. Alright, so 21st place, maybe. I don't think there's many more people out there. but if we go a lap down, then we could lose a few more. But it doesn't look like there's a whole lot of people back behind the leader that are on our lap. Somehow Don in the 22 lost the lap, so he must have sped, or I don't know what he did. Maybe missed the pits at one point. Hard to tell. Happened to this guy. I don't know if we can even pass him as loose as I am.
31.136. Outside. Keep low. Clear outside.
Okay. He's giving up. I don't know if he needs short on fuel. That's a weird one. Gives us a chance at a top 20. Might be able to hold on to 19th, I don't know. We'll see how aggressive Larry gets. I think he's just gonna blow past us though. One little bobble like that, and here he comes. That was nearly fucking wall. We were almost dead there. Can we stay on the lead lap?
31.326.
Let's try not to overdrive 1 and 2, not get too loose. Luckily the leader is in a race. They'll just pull over if they get to us, which they are going to, it looks like. Much faster through 1 and 2. Smoke on the front stretch.
31.265. You've got 2 laps to go.
Leader's going to be getting the white flag this time. He's not racing really hard with the guy behind him, so I'm not going to worry about it too much.
31.3. White flag this time.
You can just chill the fuck out and win the race and let me finish on the lead lap. Alright. Well, the strategy was terrible, but we had to try something. We still gained a few spots because there were issues out there somewhere, but... yeah, 20th place as the 25 car. I guess we can take that as a win. We just were not in it ever.
All right, there's the ticket flag.
I did not have enough control of the car, and yeah, just very bad. Just never felt comfortable, and then we were always just in a hole on some stupid stuff on the start. So let's take a look at 53.35 on the right side. So we were a little loose. That's a bit more than you want. Was it 15% almost? A little over 15. So kind of what you want. We just need to have some talent to hang on to it when it's that loose. Let's go through and see. There shouldn't be too many things to look at. I don't even think there'll be that many wall hits. First, I want to see what the fuck happened on the grid. Like, why was this guy stopping? I don't get what he was doing there. Doesn't make any sense unless he like backed off pit road or something. I don't know. That was weird and stupid. Then we got this dumbass trying to run into us on the straightaway for dead last. Fucking setup idiots. The 8 drives through the grass. Prediction. A little bit of prediction. They're still having fun and nearly wrecks the 14. Yeah, the 23 didn't seem too bright out there with his car positioning, and it also seemed like his car was running all around. Alright, so I don't know what the hell just happened to the 24 here. He just hit the wall and it sent him to the inside, or maybe he had... I don't know. Maybe a wheel issue? I'm gonna get to... We don't need to see wall hits. Into car pitting. Yeah, just not paying attention. The guy likes to run into things. Then... Oh! 14 goes for the ride. That's how he ends up back with us. Just got a little loose off the corner. He's had a rough race. So we're going to get the yellow coming up in a few laps. Pushing hard into the wall. Thought maybe that was going to be the wreck, but it wasn't. Stuck on pay to wreck, so all right, well, looks like it's broken. Let's find the caution, which is going to be now. Look. Self-spins. Yeah, he's not even trying to save it. And then just parks it on the road. This guy is such a dick. Like, it seems like he tries to take out everyone he can when shit doesn't go his way. Alright, well, that was that. That was on 75. Let's go to the next one. Just gonna be up here. Oh, the 8 blew up. And the 16 didn't know it, and the 31 was turning down. That's just... there's nothing you can do about that. That's just a shitty situation for everyone. And then we went the rest of the way, didn't we? Yeah. So, you know what? Pretty boring race. Especially from my seat, because we were not really racing anyone on the same strategy ever. And when we were, they were way faster. So, let's take a look. We gained one I rating, so there you go, 40-20, gain 0.9 safety rating, we get 118 points, and let me quickly check and see where that moves us into points now. Not that I care about points, but I know people ask, so trying to look after the race now. Let's see if it's got this one updated yet. It does. So we're not going to really gain too much. I mean, we're just gaining whatever the difference was between our worst race, which there's quite a few of them out there. So we're 16th in Division 2. That doesn't matter. We're 30th overall right now. And, yeah, as you can see, there's people ahead of us that have not done much racing. So almost to the front page. Well, look at this guy. This guy's only got 18 weeks counted and is way ahead of us. So, we're slow. We don't get good points, but it is what it is. So, hope you enjoyed the race. Tried to make it exciting. Tried some different stuff. At least we got a lot of green running in. So, thanks for watching.